In the interface of monolix, you can easily define a random effect for a parameter and add a covariate effect on its fixed effect. However, if you wish to apply a covariate effect on the standard deviation of the random effect as well, you need to define the random effect in the structural model file. Let me show you how to do this. Let's start with this simple monolix project. The model has three parameters, Ka, V and Cl, and I can see their formulae by clicking here. The dataset contains a categorical covariate called status that has two categories, diseased and healthy. If I assume that diseased patients and healthy volunteers have a different typical clearance value, I can easily define in the interface a covariate effect of status on the clearance parameter Cl by clicking here. I can check on the formula that the covariate effect is added to the fixed effect. However, it is also possible that diseased and healthy individuals have a similar typical clearance but a different inter-individual variability for Cl, which means that the standard deviation of the random effect eta Cl should differ between groups. I cannot define this effect on this tab, but I can define it in the structural model. Here is again the formula for Cl when the random effect is defined in the interface with a log-normal distribution. To define a covariate effect on omega Cl, the standard deviation of the random effect eta Cl, I must define the random effect in the structural model rather than in the interface, such that two different random variables, eta Cl diseased and eta Cl healthy, will be applied to Cl depending on the covariate value. Two standard deviations, omega Cl diseased and omega Cl healthy, will then be estimated. To be able to use the information from the covariate in the structural model, it must be defined in the dataset as a regressor with integer values. Therefore, I have introduced a column regstatus in my dataset, which is a duplicate of status where diseased patients are indicated with the value 0 and healthy volunteers are indicated with 1. I tag this column as a regressor. I can now modify the structural model. Here is the initial structural model with a simple PK model, and here is the modified structural model. The fixed effect Cl pop and the two random effects for Cl are given as input, as well as the reg status, which is defined as a regressor. The parameter Cl is then computed directly in the model with the correct random effect depending on the value of reg status with an if-else statement. If reg status is 0, the random effect used is eta Cl diseased, otherwise it is eta Cl healthy. I can now load this modified model. Finally, I remove the random effect for Cl pop in the tab Statistical Model and Tasks since it is already included in the structural model. I must also take into account the fact that eta Cl diseased and eta Cl healthy are random effects, so I choose a normal distribution for each of them. And in the tab Initial Estimates, I fix their typical value to 0. Two standard deviations, omega eta Cl diseased and omega eta Cl healthy, will now be estimated for the clearance in each group. Note that if I also want to estimate different typical values for Cl pop in each group, I can still define a covariate effect of status on Cl pop in the interface with this box. To sum up, the recipe to define different standard deviations for two categories A and B for the random effect of a parameter P is in three steps. First, define the covariate as a regressor in the dataset. Then, in the structural model file, define as distinct parameters the typical value for the parameters and the two standard deviations, and define the random effect with an if statement and the regressor. Finally, in the Statistical Model and Tasks tab, make sure to remove the random effect for the typical value of the parameter and to choose normal distributions for the standard deviations, as well as to fix their means to 0. You can find a similar example on our online documentation at this address. See you next week!